In this tutorial, we will try to explain step by step how to do background removal and decoupage operations in MS Paint with all its features. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. We open MS Paint and start with a clean and blank canvas with a white background color. For background removal and decoupage, we will use a screenshot of our desktop wallpaper as material. You can erase, crop and decoupage the background of any image or photo using the techniques we'll show you. After taking a screenshot, we placed it on our canvas with the selection tool. Since MS Paint does not have an external layer system, we expand our canvas horizontally to save space. We focus on the white chess pawn knight in the center of our wallpaper and create a copy with a rough selection of rectangles, but we could have done without the backup. Since we are showing it here for teaching purposes, and we will show it both through copies and by comparing multiple methods, we will try to explain it step by step through copies. The first method we will demonstrate is to selectively separate the image from the background with the freeform selection tool. We have proportionally increased the size of the image with resizing to show it better and closer and to work in detail. With the freeform selection tool, we can separate the image from the background with a single selection. But working in detail and being able to check for possible errors and proceeding step by step gives more flexibility and avoids a possible error and total waste of time and effort. In a sense, it is a divide and conquer process. In the process, it is important to approach the image to be chosen and define the borders precisely. The more careful and attentive it is chosen, the cleaner the result will be. If you did it a bit fast, like we did, you can use brush tools at the end to touch up and file off the excess. In fact, the most practical method is to use the bucket tool to eliminate the monochrome background using color differences. Unfortunately, it is not possible here if you notice there are too many intermediate tones in our piece, so this procedure is not suitable for this work. Some of the techniques we covered in our image tracking methods tutorial are also useful here for background removal and decoupage. With the line tool and the curve tool, we draw the image at its borders, and then with the freeform selection tool, we can remove it in a much more practical and less inaccurate way. Another version of the method we have just shown is to apply a mask method to separate the outlined image from the background in one go. For this method, it is necessary to apply the first parts of the first method. Therefore, we will be explaining the continuation of the process in practice with the copy we have taken from the video surveillance. We will go over the contrasting colors that we use in image tracking so that those who watched the previous lesson will understand this lesson much more effectively. In the previous image tracking tutorial, we set our outline to black. In this case, the black color contrasts very well with the outline background color and is therefore very appropriate. With the bucket tool, we immediately change the outline colors to black. The next operation is to invert the colors. To remove all shades of gray and other colors other than black and white, we change the color properties in the file menu from color format to black and white format and save the resulting outline drawing by cropping the shape. After all these actions, we reopen the record of our work from the previous phase. In this case, we import our outline figure image created by cropping the work. We invert the colors of the imported chess knight pawn mask figure. After making sure that the transparent selection feature is active, we make a selection with the second color white, that is, the background color white, and place it like a mask on the image, whose background we want to delete.
In the last step, we use the bucket tool to change the color of the mask area from a single black color to white, so that the background is completely cleared. When decoupage with masking, we can also use the primitive basic shape tools in combination with other methods.
For example, after defining the boundaries of an image fragment that is a complete circle in the image with the oval tool, we can separate it from the background in a similar way to what we did in the last example, but in an even simpler way.
Because the mask of this image fragment can be easily created by combining two basic shapes.
As a general summary, we organize our canvas to show all the stages and methods we have gone through up to this point on a single canvas. Yes, we have come to the end of this training content.
If you haven't seen it, we recommend you to watch the previous and subsequent trainings of the series. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon.
Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.